Loaded up, Carl. This shit feel like game 7. Put lines up through my S's. Wake up in the morning, count my blessings.
Welcome to the Money Down. And, you know, speaking of money, we got a few dudes get paid in the NFL today. We got Jared Goff signed his four-year, $212 million
extension
with the Detroit Lions. I don't know what y'all feel about that. I think he deserves it.
Well deserved.
You know, I feel like, you know, coming from the Rams, Warren's team, you know, they kind of gave him the boot, left him out to dry, thinking he was going to go to Detroit and, you know, not be all that. And he kind of found new life. He's a leader of that football team. I've been truly impressed with the way he's performed, you know, taking his team to the playoffs this past year. Potentially could have, you know, found themselves in the Super Bowl. They didn't. But right now, I think they're at the top of, you know, that NFC North division. I don't know how y'all feel about Goff getting paid.
Man, I'm a caveat it with, you know, we did get a Super Bowl out of it with Matt Stafford, so I'm cool us giving Jared Goff the boot. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie to you. I mean, even though he's a great quarterback, you know, he's done, hats off to him. Like, he's really helped the struggling Detroit team. He turned it around. He's helped them turn it around. So, heck yeah, he deserves that contract. I mean, the man's been balling, you know, 3,000 pass yards a season, if I'm not mistaken. I mean, he deserves it. He's leading that offense. And, you know, without him, I don't know if anybody else can do the job that he's doing. So definitely he fits that. Yeah. He fits that offense like very well.
Yeah, like everybody's been saying, well deserved. I was one of them people. I for some reason, like, he's one of my favorite quarterbacks in the league. Right. He always remind me of that Jake Cutler gunslinger. Phillip Rivers just going, you know what I'm saying? No matter if he throw a pick or not, you know that next drive, he going to go out there and he going to throw that motherfucker.
Yeah.
So, you know, but what he was able to do for a franchise like Detroit, right, that's been, you know, y'all are hearing me say it all the time, Detroit need Batman. Like, the same bad city, they need a superhero. And, you know, how he was able to come in and play in this, change the energy and everything around it. Like, you could truly tell just – with the fan base, the fans were, you know, excited to be able to rep, you know what I'm saying, that blue and silver or blue and gray. Yeah. And, you know, I just want to continue to see them improve. You get what I'm saying? Like, I really wanted them to be in the Super Bowl this year, because that would have been, you know, I just think that that window can close so fast, man. Yeah. So they are definitely on the up and up, and you know what I'm saying? Detroit been paying that bread this offseason.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
They're right there too. The receiver, they knocking on the door.
Paid a lineman like 100 M's too. So you know what I'm saying? They doing what's necessary to keep that core and those guys together. And, you know, just got to keep improving. But JG, well-deserved.
I was going to say, bro, and if we remember last year, you know, was it first week of the season or first 2 weeks, they beat Super Bowl champs. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Had they made the Super Bowl, bro, that would have been the game. Like, for sure. I'm not saying that San Fran wasn't the game, but that would have been like redemption for Kansas City, but an opportunity for Detroit to really put their stamp.
Yeah. Detroit, it's up right now in Detroit. I mean, they went from, you know, being, you know, hunters. Now they the hunted. You know, they everybody gunning to try and get them at this point. They ain't no, you know, hoorah stuff. It's like now, you know, you got to get your best shot every single week. Everybody coming to beat Detroit, which is, you know, a little bit different than, you know, in previous, what, like 20, 30, 40 years in Detroit. So it's definitely a different feel. But congrats to Jared Goff on that new contract. The other guy who got paid today, Antoine Winfield, becomes the highest paid NFL DB in the history of the game. 4 year, $84.1 million contract, $45 million guaranteed. So he's making, you know, over $20 million a year at safety.
Bag.
It's unheard of, for real. Because what we've seen this past offseason, you know, Quandre Diggs, Justin Simmons, guys getting released, not even making remotely close to that much. So big ups to him resetting that market. You know, some other guys, some young bucks are probably excited. And this is what I'm trying to see from the running back market. But what y'all think about, you know, Antoine Winfield getting that over $20 million a year at the safety position?
We kind of hit it on it, like, bro, he deserve it. And I'm hating a little bit just for the simple fact that he went to Minnesota, you know what I'm saying?
Well,
I don't like them people, but, you know, I was able to, you know, play him while I was there at Wisconsin. And, again, always been a player that had a knack for the ball, just going to be around it. He's a game changer. He's going to make plays. Then he got to the league and did the same thing. But the thing that's so dope to me about him is – He's that piece that you could put anywhere. You know what I'm saying? You want to play nickel, he could play nickel. You want to bring him in the box where he got a blitz, he got a tackle, he got to tackle these big backs, and, you know, he'll do all that. He'll stick his head in there. So, and then you throw him, he's around the ball, he causing strips, you know, strips, picks. So for him to get paid like that, he is well deserved. And you know, when you do that, that's already going to be on your back. So you're going to have a lot of coaches now trying to that game plan. A lot of the times when you go on meetings, you know, Winfield going to be circled. But he's the player to, you know, continue to change that culture in Tampa and continue to get them to be better. And, you know, I'm happy for him.
About you, Juan, what you think about Winfield, man?
Bump Minnesota, but anyway. make sure I threw that in there. Bump Minnesota. I don't want to say what I want to say. I'm trying to be a good role model for the kids.
Get off your chest, man. Play it with your chest.
You hear me? You hear me? But nah, but as a Buck, bro, like, he deserves it. I mean, rangy player. And the thing that I like about him, man, he's not afraid to play in the box. He's not afraid to come up and make a tackle. He's a physical player. Again, like we talked about, make plays on the ball in the air. I think he deserves it. Now, I'm going to be a hater because I think that it's some other safeties in the league that I think are better. You know, no offense to him. Like I said, he's elite. He deserves the bread. But, you know, I'm excited to see what happens with some of the younger safeties in the league, you know, like Jesse Bates. You know, obviously Minka Fitzpatrick ain't one of the younger ones anymore, but I think Minka might be the best safety in the league. So I'm waiting to see how much he get paid, you know, like a guy that's a veteran that's been doing it for a while and been consistent with it. You know, like I said, Jesse Bates, things like that. So I'm excited to see what happens with some of these other safeties that, you know, when they hit that contract year two or when they get to their next contract. But definitely 100% well-deserved by Antoine Winfield. The man's a baller. Can't keep him out of it.
What's crazy to me is, like, we still got some safeties out there this past season that, you know, got let go from their teams that are still gamers. So it's going to be real interesting to see when they come to the table and they figure out what team they going to. Justin Simmons, Quantre Diggs, like when them guys go to whatever team it is and they say, man, shoot, Tampa just paid X, Y, and Z this amount of money. Like, I know I'm on the back end and I've gotten older, but hell, I still deserve half or, you know what I'm saying, a little bit over, you know, half of what he getting, you know what I'm saying? So
that's a good point, because you got a guy like you just mentioned, what's his name?
Justin Simmons,
who's been in the league longer, who's been just as consistent.
He's the best safety in the league.
I mean, he's one of them. Yeah.
He's the best safety in the league.
Okay.
I like Simmons. I compete against him. He got me a few times. I rock with Winfield, though. That versatility, that's what I like. You play the middle of the field, play the slot. You can blitz, get sacks, you know, defeat blocks, you know, play the run, could play some man. He's not like a lockdown man player, but he's going to compete. You know, Todd Bowles is going to put him in some crazy situations. Like when they played the Rams in the NFC Championship, had him guarding friend Cooper Kupp for the game. That ain't the right matchup. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, I like him. I love versatile players, though. He's definitely one of them, always around the ball. He's been like that since, you know, playing for Minnesota. So, definitely hats off to him. But turn the page a little bit to, you know, two rookies, Jay Daniels, Malik Nabers, they call off they 10K betting on who's going, you know, win rookie of the year. I guess, you know, they hadn't gone through their whole gambling speech. Now, I mean, they should have went through it at the combine, I'm sure.
Yeah.
But, them boys crazy, man. These young dudes different, man. Put it out there in the media that they doing a 10K bet. I mean, like I said, this ain't a bad thing because, look, they going out there performing. Ain't like they hindering their performance. They probably going to, you know, up their performance trying to, you know, outdo their counterpart. But these young dudes different.
They said Malik Nabers seen Daniel Jones ain't got it.
That's why I think it started. He probably hit him up and be like, bro, hey, I'm gonna need that guy.
But man, what kills me and gets me, dog, about this whole thing, even, you know, even with the league, obviously the rules are the rules. You know, no betting, no gambling, X, Y, and Z, but bro, it's everywhere. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I just don't understand. It's like anything that is an addiction or whatever it is. If you put it out there and enough people get their hands on it and they start doing it, it's gonna trickle in. So I'm watching playoff basketball last night. And after the game, as soon as the game ends, if you have a gambling addiction, call this like
1-800. I got a problem.
You feel me? Like, why is there not a commercial on Spalding basketball being for sale or jerseys being for sale? Like, the first thing I seen after the game was a game. Like, do you have a gambling addiction? And that's what the culture is now. No matter, I don't care what people say. everybody, if you could put money on something, man, you could make a little cheese. So for the NFL, I know it shouldn't be out there, but it shouldn't be a surprise to people in the league that even, you know, people are making these, you know, comments. And then especially the younger dudes, James, you say it all the time, like, the young dudes different, man. It's a different culture from when you got in the league. You feel me? So it just is what it is. I mean, if that's going to make them go out there and game better, man, I don't think the Commanders, you know what I'm saying, or the Giants care for real. Like, if that's going to make you go out there and hoop and game better, then, hey, I'm for it. But,
I mean, if you think about it, the people that's cracking down and whatnot is – league management. It ain't the teams. The teams don't make a move until the league say something for real.
Yeah, but I mean,
and the league promoting that. And shit. The league promoting
it, bro. You know, the players want a piece of that bread. For sure. You know what I'm saying? Why not bet on yourself, like we say? You know, put your money down.
it come out. You shaving points or something like that. That's crazy, right? You come out, you betting on other people. Yeah, but let players bet on themselves. Let's bet on their team that week. They lose the cheese. That's game check gone.
Yeah, that is different. And speaking of where these guys coming from, you know, the NCAA, you know, has a multi-billion-dollar antitrust settlement that may happen to where, you know, potentially there will be no more like NIL deals. The universities will be able to, you know, pay the players directly. I don't know what's y'all thoughts on that. I think that's probably the right direction this whole thing needs to go. There needs to be some type of, you know, governing on, so everybody can see what exactly each player is getting paid, all these contracts, so it could be kind of a set structure versus, you know, this guy, you know, signs here because he's promised, you know, 200K, you know, to little Ray Ray them. If you sign with us and then you get there, you'll never see that 200K, but you sign, you stuck there. I feel like that's a part of the reason why some of these kids be transferring, you know, left and right, because, you know, these NIL deals, it ain't always what it, you know, 100%. You know, comes out to be. Some of these guys get screwed over by whether it's the agent, the school, whatever it may be, just to make sure they sign that. So I think this is a step in the right direction. I don't know how soon this happens, whether it's, you know, before this season or next season. I think this is on the right track to kind of get things back on track for college football.
Run that back. I think it's good, and I think it's a long time coming. You know, I think it's about time that the schools start cutting a check to the players. You know, I think it's, you know, all the media money they make and all that stuff, the advertising and whatnot. Like, I think it's about time that they pay the players. And I actually think that would be a good substitution for the NIL. Yeah. The hard part is you have players that command a level of attention that, you know, that they want more, right? And I don't think NIL is a bad thing, because you are, you know, allowing a kid to make money on their likeness, their step, you know, being in commercials, and people want to see that. And people have, you know, people have already responded to things like that, right? You know, you got, you know, women's college basketball players in commercials now that people love watching, you know, college, you know, men's collegiate players that people enjoy watching and things like that. Like, people enjoy that. So I think that's the hard part, is that you're probably going to take more out of the players' pockets. But on the flip side of that, from a school standpoint, like, how do you make it fair for all the athletes? Because some athletes may be like, hey, I'm coming in, like, you know, everybody's wanting to watch this program because I'm the number one recruit in the country, and I decide to come here. Like, why am I making the same amount as this walk-on? It's a lot of details that are going to have to be ironed out to make sure that it's fair across the board. And who knows what is fair right now, you know? But it's a lot of conversation. But I do like it that the schools are going to be paying the players. I think that's the best way moving forward.
Yeah, I think they should keep both, honestly.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think NIL will go away.
Well, I figured they're going to do one or the other.
No, I don't think so. I think endorsements will still be in place for sure. Like,
okay, that's cool.
You still get your, you know, get paid from the school, but you can still make, you know, whatever, get signed by Gatorade, Pepsi. I would assume that's
okay. That's cool. Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, so I mean, I just think they keep both, and then, you know, my thing is, man, the schools make the bread. They got the bread, man. Mm-hmm. Pay that money. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just remember when I was in college, seeing like, damn, Wisconsin made this much. Right under us or right above us was like Texas and Bama. Like, we made like the third most in the country off, you know, Bachelor football. So it's enough of the pie to be able to be spread out all over. Warren, like you brought up, that is kind of like a concerning thing, you know, number one player or a top recruit or a top guy, you know, getting the same amount of money as, you know, yeah, somebody like a walk-on or whatnot. But I just think, you know, I just think it should be scaled, right? If you yeah. are freshman, you are this, you know yeah. what I'm saying? If you're a freshman, you get this amount. And as you get old, you know, as you get older, you're probably your sophomore or junior year. That's when you could really make the big bucks if you yeah. if you become one of those top dogs on your team. But when I seen that shit, I ain't gonna lie, y'all boys, I thought we might have got a little back. Man, where the back pay? Because if I wasn't, when we was gaming, would have been college, man. We would have. I could have at least left with
it. You just seen the strike. Look at that.
What Denzel say? I'm leaving here with something.
I'm leaving here with something. So when I saw that, that's where it came. I'm like, man. On them, they gonna get their brand. What a back pain settlement at.
I wish, man. I don't think they ever do that because they have to cough up so much bread. You know, yeah, some of them top dogs gonna be like, hey, like, I need all that back, them Heisman Trophy winners and all that. But yeah, when it comes to the schools paying the players, I think it would have to be like a set structure. Like freshman makes this, sophomore makes this, junior makes this, senior makes this. Like, I don't really think you should be able to structure it based on, you know, performance, because I think that's when it kind of gets the gray area. I feel like NIL and endorsement deals, yeah, that should be based off your play, obviously. You get more notoriety you bring to the program and to yourself, you get all those, like I said, the Gatorade deals, Lululemon, you know, all that other stuff. Just so it's fair to, you know, all the other players. Because look, like some of the guys, you know, at the end of the roster or, you know, may not be playing, they deserve to get paid too. They're on scholarship. Maybe they don't get that many reps, but hey, you're still on scholarship. Just get them your check. And then the rest of the big dogs, you get paid off the endorsement. Just kind of like, I mean, I know in the NFL, you know, you get paid based on performance and you can get the endorsements on top of that. I don't think college should necessarily be that, because that will start to get a little crazy when you start seeing like, oh, this guy signed to Alabama. He signed for his, whatever, three to 4 years, $2 million, like scholarship. That'd be insane if it gets to like that point. You see on the ESPN ticker, you know, this five-star recruit, he signed his 3 to 4 year deal for $2 million to go here. That'd be insane.
but you know what? I also do think it is a little beneficial, because maybe this will teach these young dudes how to handle that cheese before they get to the league. You know what I'm saying? And we're seeing that a lot now. Like, and Bron came out, you know, this not to switch over to the basketball, but Bron came out a couple months ago and he talked about just, you know, like he's seeing so much of the young guys in the culture, right? It's about the cars. It's about the jury. It's about, you know, X, Y, and Z. And if you stick to your profession and you do what you're supposed to do, that'll come along as you grow.
Yeah.
But I think if you give these college players an opportunity to kind of see what that money feel like before they really get to, you know, the millions of dollars, then it can help, you know what I'm saying? It maybe help you out in some type of financial literacy at any point.
Yeah, most definitely. I think that would definitely be dope. I mean, I just hope the hunger will still be the same for all these guys. Because, you know what I'm saying? You get $2 million in college, man. I mean, you may be making more than what you make in your rookie contract. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So, will the hunger still be the same? Will these guys still even want to make it to – which, I mean, nothing wrong with that. You don't have to go to the NFL. There's other plenty of things to do. But will the product of the NFL still be, you know, as great as what it is, guys making millions and millions and millions of dollars in college football? Before we continue, let's have a word from our sponsor, Prize Picks. It's NBA playoff time, so make sure you head over to Prize Picks and bet over or under on some of your favorite athletes' projected stats. And when you use our promo code MONEYDOWN, Prize Picks will match up to $500 on your first deposit. I repeat, when you use our promo code MONEYDOWN, Prize Picks will match up to $500 on your first deposit. You can bet small and win big prizes. Now, speaking of the NIL deal, what NIL deal would you wish you would have had if you was at UW at the time?
We being realistic, or
I mean, you can shoot whatever you. I don't know. It's.
I'm just saying, for me, y'all was some big dogs. So I'm saying, for me personally.
I mean,
I don't like Culver's.
Yeah, Culver's was fire.
Yes, I don't like Culver's.
Bro. I was going to say, like, this is going to sound crazy to people not from Wisconsin, but the Babcock, like the ice cream and like that, that I've been fired to be sponsored,
fire for sure.
Sponsored by them, get milk, ice cream on the regular for the free ski.
I'm going to stick with Culver's. I think Culver's
would have
been fire.
Yeah, Culver's been dope.
That's a dope question, dog.
I'm trying to think. Hey, Stella's. You that Stella's?
Stella's. I ain't gonna lie, man. Give me the tornado room. Give me the tornado room. NIL deal, man.
Man, that's a good question.
Yeah. Saturday night after that's the game.
After the games hit the fan, during the week, take my girl. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, maybe. Hey, also the UW Credit Union.
Yeah, that would be fire.
I was thinking too, like Qdoba. Like I'm just thinking like the stuff that we really and like Madison. And Madison that we
get
you know
that year, get that year of free burrito. Yeah. Get a burrito a day.
Shoot,
or we kind of had that though. Fresh Mart, bro. The Fresh Market deal.
That's what I say. Either like a Fresh Market, or even for one of the apartment complexes too. Pay for that.
Yeah,
pay for that rent.
Yeah.
Sure. Living good on campus.
Sure.
Yeah. Living real good.
I feel like them boys living good and not old. Like a couple of the boys I follow that's still, you know what I'm saying? Them boys vibing good. Them boys be in Chicago. Yeah, all type of whip side. I said, what are you? Them boys, but they deserve it though. They hanging
for sure.
Good, man.
For sure.
Yeah, for sure. And speaking of college football as well, we just got some news. You know, today on like Twitter, X, whatever you want to call it, is potentially a $150 premium edition of EA College Football. If you're gonna purchase that expensive version,
they're trying to make that money back from what they paying the players.
I mean, you ain't got to pay the $150.
No, you ain't got to.
You paid it whatever $70.
But you know, those people that's gonna want it.
People gonna pay. Y'all got somebody on the. I'm paying the $150.
You paying your bad?
Yeah,
Would you want the game to come with if you paid the $150?
You know what's so crazy, dog? Like I don't and when they brought that out, it just gave me that old feeling of like when video games came out. Like I remember when Call of Duty was coming out, they would have a Hardened Edition, and they would have the regular video game, they would have a Hardened Edition, and then they would have like a veteran edition that came with like, you know, like night vision goggles and stuff. Yeah, like you know what I'm saying? Like some exclusive stuff like that. So I'm hoping that that's what college football is going to with, you know, that pricing of it. Now, what they put in it, I don't know, because obviously we haven't seen any gameplay or we don't know what modes and stuff are going to be in the game. But I just think it would be super dope for them to, you know what I'm saying, throw some like little gifts in that pack, because $150 is steep, man.
That's a lot.
Maybe some additional NIL money for your program.
Your little extra cheese. I don't know what they could include in that. It got to be something dope. Maybe something, you know, specified to whatever college you're a fan of or something. So I mean, I don't know, some gear.
Send you some merch with the purchase or something.
Yes, I mean something. I know, like somebody was saying, like MLB The Show is like an exclusive hat that you buy, that you get if you buy like a certain edition. Mm-hmm. I don't know what they could do to make it potentially worth your while, but I'm sure it has something to do. You know, Madden has Ultimate Team. I could almost guarantee, you know, this college football going to have some version of Ultimate Team. So I'm sure it's going to be some season pass. You probably get the first couple season passes included, which. That's what video games is, thanks to Fortnite. A bunch of microtransactions. You're going to be spending that check, and I'm sure they're going to find a way to get it, you know, out of all of us as far as spending the money. So I don't know what you think, Warren.
That'd be cold and this is like obviously unrealistic. It could be though, but it'd be cold if they did like the first like 200 people to purchase the $150 game get like a free ticket to the national championship
football
game.
Or a college football
playoff game of their choice or something, you know?
Yeah.
I think that would be cool. Obviously, I think that's like unrealistic.
You know how hard that's going to be?
Yeah, 100%. 100%. 100%. 100%.
Everybody. But something like that would be dope. Like,
that'd be dope. That'd like be dope. But I would think like you know, having like classic teams, like being able to
get
you know, national championship teams or classic rosters or something like that, getting like 5 to 10 like classic rosters. Yeah. I think that'd be cool. That you can't get otherwise unless you like take the time to create them yourself. Yeah.
But I feel like I feel like that should be included in the games where you could you play with like
already be
all the missing years. You should be able to go back and play whatever. 2010 Wisconsin, 2011 was that'd be fire.
They
do that. That's dope, boy. Yeah. Turn back the
clock. With all this time they taking, they should be doing it already.
Yeah, I mean, what 2K do it with the the little online play, play with the whatever the 06, 07 Heat or the all time.
But you can't do like every team in every year.
Nah. Just like the big time schools, probably like the top top 25 teams from that year.
Each year,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that'd be dope.
Yeah, that'd be some fire. I feel like they should kick in something like that, and that'd be cool. I guess to wrap this up, man, the WNBA season about to be kicking off. I don't know what you guys looking forward to this year. I think it's going to be exciting. Obviously, all eyes be on Caitlin Clark and this rookie class.
She's been hooping, too.
Yeah, she's been hooping.
Her and Angel Reese.
Yeah.
Angel Reese
been hooping. So, I saw Rike, too, in the little preseason game.
Yeah, she was cooking.
You know, with Caitlin Clark hit the buzzer beater, so she's been like that, too. So, it's going to be a fun year. I know the vets, they excited to get this class in. They want to prove that they've been doing this. I hope there's a lot more attention towards a lot more games on national television so everybody can see, because I think the product's going to keep getting better and better and better, which it was already very good. But obviously with the college game, getting so much notoriety over the last few years, now those girls, those big-time players from there getting to the WNBA, it's going to be dope, man. Even they got some Sabrina Ionescu. Can't forget about her. She's dropping her next shoe.
Asia Wilson.
So what y'all looking forward to?
It's that time of the year where we're always normally fetching for something to watch, right? Like, you're getting to the point where the NBA playoffs is kind of slowing down. We're going to have a champion to crown this year. Baseball is always long. Hockey about to end. And then kind of like June, July, it's just this gap of like, bro, I need football to start or something. But we finally have something to substitute that gap, man. Mm-hmm. Like, I will be honest with you, I didn't tune into women's basketball as much as I do now. Like, I'm dead ass trying to see. Like, I want to see Caitlin Clark hoop just because, Diana Taurasi said, like, oh, it's not going to be easy. But so far in the playoff, I'm not in the preseason, she cooking. Like,
she making it look easy.
She making it look easy. And then I seen, like, other night, she had, like, maybe 14 points, but she had, like, 9 assists.
Yeah.
And, she said something like, oh, I feel like I didn't really contribute. And her her teammate was like, what? Like, you know what I'm saying?
She used to put up 30-40 a game.
You spacing the floor for us, saying? For somebody else like myself to cook tonight. So I'm excited, man, for it to get going. It's super competitive. It's a lot of attention to it. A lot of the NBA players that's not participating in the Olympics gonna be courtside watching the women play. And it's just an exciting time, man, especially for that gap I was talking about. We got something in it where we can actually, watch and enjoy as sports fans.
It's going to be fire, too. I think, especially Caitlin Clark games, they're going to be sold out. You already seen, like, Travis Scott pulled up to one of her games at Iowa. I think I seen, the Jake from State Farm in one of the games. So people pulling up to the college game. So people pulling up, courtside, all that. So I think that's going to be a dope experience for them. Obviously more attention on it. They won't want to, be at the top of their game. It's going to be dope, man. I'm about to check it out. Caitlin Clark ain't too far away.
Now that they're generating so much buzz and they're taking over that, like, and I don't want to call it a dead period because the women have always been in that place. Right. But now now we're not going to have as much as a period between like the NBA playoffs and the Stanley Cup and NFL. Like, now they're filling that gap. With how many people are going to be watching games now because of these girls that just came out of college, bro? There is no excuse not to pay these women. Like, they're gonna make some money now, So I mean, I'm looking forward to that, seeing how much more these women can make. The women can make, in the WNBA based off of this time period. Now that more people are gonna watch, and their next TV deal is coming up super soon. So
what you said, James, was like, people don't really understand how crazy that is. People were we've played at the University of Iowa.
Yep.
Ain't shit in Iowa. Literally, quick story. We on the bus ride because Iowa was one of those games that we bus to. I literally remember like riding on the bus and seeing a truck, like cornfields, but I seen a truck full of pigs. And I get my head, I was like, damn, these pigs don't even know, man. This like, but it just ain't nothing out there. That's the type of stuff you see. So for stars like Travis Scott and State Farm, for them to pull up and go to Iowa, like, I don't even know where you fly at. I don't even know what airport you fly into.
Des Moines.
You know what I'm saying? Like, which I don't even think, I think it's like an hour or two away from University of Iowa. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, for those type of stars that pull up to University of Iowa and watch her, you know, hoop, like, it's definitely going to be a lot of attention and a lot of big dogs. Now you're going to see courtside of them games. Kind of like when you see Laker games.
Yeah.
You see all these movie stars and these, you know, these sports figures and everything. It's going to be like that for the women. And I'm ultra excited, man.
Yeah.
Because like I said, they deserve it too. We all deserve it because we all grinding and putting in, you know, maximum effort and the things that the people don't see. So pay them as such.
Yeah, for sure. And it's going to be a lot of people making a huge investment into it too, especially with all these, everybody watching all that. I think I seen Serena Williams potentially thinking about putting some money in all that. I think Dwayne Wade is already an investor with the Chicago, you know, Skies team. So it's going to be more and more people doing that with all this talent being in there, a lot of attention being on it. So I think everything's going to start coming together and they'll be getting paid the money they deserve. But that's a wrap for this Money Down episode. We appreciate you guys liking, subscribing, commenting. We appreciate all the love. Be more exclusive content coming soon. Interviews, just us. More fire. Appreciate y'all. More fire.
You know. Yeah.
If y'all want to see Warren's booth, man, come on. Like, comment, we want to hear Warren sing, man.
I say y'all. To my family, every song I ever wrote. This shit feel like Game 7. Put lines up through my essence.